Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel SFDC Panther. This is Amit and in this video we will learn how we can debug our project with the help of AnyPoint Studio. So let's see what we have in our plate for today. In next 20 minutes we will learn how we can debug our project using breakpoints, and then after that we are going to execute our breakpoints in based on expression, based on a condition. For example, we have different methods. A listener is listening and we wanted to execute our breakpoint only if a method is post, and then after we will see how we can jump up or how we can skip a particular process or the complete flow while we are debugging our application, so that we can actually debug whatever we wanted to debug, and then we will see how we can actually evaluate our expression with the help of our expression evaluator. Before we go ahead, we have some points that we have a single point that we need to remember is, by default Mule debugger runs at port 6666. If you are not able to execute your debug on the same port, that means your machine is using this port, and then you can change, and we will see how we can change that. For example, here is a simple flow where we have a listener which is listening on an endpoint that is debug, and we have a transform message, which is our favorite message for transforming a metadata to a different outputs, like from CSV to XML, data view, Java, and we are going to put our breakpoint at this transform message, and then at the end we have a logger where we will actually see what output we are getting in the from the listener. So let's quickly start that. For this tutorial I am using MuleSoft version 7.4. if you are using 7.3 or 7.2, that is also not an issue, because here there is no rule of version of the studio. Even if you wanted to migrate or if you wanted to update your studio to the latest version, which is 7.4, you can go to menu AnyPoint Studio. From there you can select about AnyPoint Studio, and here you will see installation detail. Once you click here, it will open a new window. In this window you will see update option, and once you will click update, it will check for updates, and then after it will pop you up that there are software updates. If not, then you will see a window like this. So we are going to create a complete new project because this project is already created. So to create a project, just right click on canvas if you wanted to create a project from here, or you can use this menu at the top. You can just click on this menu and here you can select Mule project, or you can go to your Mule file and then from there you can create a new project. So there are multiple ways to create a new project. My favorite is I'm going to create click on canvas, and from there I'm going to create a new Mule project. The name that I'm going to say is Training SFDC Panther. And then I'm going to click on finish. So once it will create a new project, we will see a complete new canvas here. So let me close my other project so that I can work on my single project only. So right click on this project and then click on close project. So now we have only one open project and we are going to work on this XML file. On the right side you can see that we have a palette where we can get multiple connectors or what. So first thing that we need to do is drag this listener into the canvas, and you will see a listener here. Now here you can see that the listener is not happy. We are able to see a red sign here. Why we are getting this red sign? Because it is saying that you are saying I'm a listener, now tell me where I need to listen. Either it is a URL, web service, or a table row, or a file handling file, anything it can be. So let's quickly click on this green plus icon, and here we are able to see that there is some by default name, by default port number, and then we have a base path. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the port number here to 8082, because 8081 is already in use is my PC. So I'm just, for the base path I'm going to use this forward slash. Now if you click on test connection, it will test and it will let you know if your connection at the port 8082 is listening successfully, or if you are getting any kind of error, and then if you need to change your port number. So let's wait and we will see a successful message here, because this port number is not in use in my PC. I'm going to cancel it because I know that it is going to give me a success message, and then after then click OK. So still we are seeing that this is not happy. So why it is not happy? Because we have some required field, that is path. So for the path, what I'm going to give it is debug. Now you can see that we have no errors, and if I try to save it, now it's happy. Next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to change the name of listener. I'm going to say that debug, so it will be a meaningful, because I'm saying that get debug. And again, go to the advanced section of this listener section, where we can define what are the methods that we wanted to listen. So for this tutorial, we are going to use two methods. One is get and post, because we are going to work on conditional breakpoints as well. I'm going to change this flow name as well. So I will say that debug flow, so that it can make sense to me. If you want to change, you can change. And here we have some initial state, either it can be stopped or started, that we will discuss later on. Now we have this flow. From the favorite section, let's quickly copy this transform message, drag and drop this transform message, and then at the end drag and drop the logger. So I'm going to change the logger name, and I will say it's as a debug logger, and I will copy this and paste this into the category section so that I can see this is a debug logger. So now, before we execute this project, let's quickly talk about input and output of a DataSense Explorer that actually automatically make a sense what is the output and how it is going to look like. So here you can see that we have a payload of undefined, because our listener don't know what kind of data we are going to get from the user, what kind of data user is going to send us, and even in the attributes we don't have anything. But if we try to click on refresh metadata, it will took some time and refresh the metadata, and we are getting the same metadata. Again, if we see the output, we are going to get, like, we have nothing in the input, we are not sending anything, because payload is the data that client is sending to us, and attributes, even we have nothing, and in the variables, inside variables, we also have nothing. If we talk about output, you can see that we are able to see some path here, and here we have a method parameter which is going to give us the method name, either it is get or post. And we have n number of things like query parameters, what query parameters we are sending, URI params, what is the path, what is the request URIs, all things that you wanted to get related to a request, you can get here. And if we go back to the transform message, the output of our this listener will be the input of this transform message. Now you can see that we have thing here, right? So let's quickly, I'm going to convert it as a JSON. So I will say convert JSON, and then in the payload, in the output, what I'm going to see here is just a payload. And once you hit control plus enter, it will automatically do a auto populate for you. And if you wanted to see the preview, click on this and then again click on preview. And here you can see that we are running preview, but still we don't have any preview that we are able to see. So now we have done this. So let's quickly see how we can put a breakpoint here. So I just let's say that I wanted to see what output we are getting from this debug. So you wanted to put a debug here. How you can do that? Just right click on this process and then click on toggle breakpoint. Once you will put that, you will see a red circle over there on the top of your process. Before that, you wanted to make sure that your debugger is running on the correct port, or you wanted to change the port. How you can do that? Click on your menu, run, and select debug configurations option. And here you will see, go to the mule debug section, and you will see a port number here. It is 6666. If your machine is using this port number, you can change this to some other port number. And now we have this project. So what we are going to do, let's close this. And now we wanted to debug this project. What we will do is right click on this canvas, click on this debug project, whatever the project name we have provided here. And once you will click here, it will ask you that you haven't saved your project. Click on save, and it will give or it will start running our project, because Mule project runs as a main project. So it will do create a dependency, and then after it will create a jar file which will be actually a runnable file for us, and then after it will try to execute our project in a test mode that we can run in either any kind of web service testing tool. It might be Postman, Advanced REST client, RESTlet client, or any other tool that you wanted to listen. So here you can see, if you will run your project into the debug mode, you will be see that a debugger will automatically be open, and on the top right you will see that there are two modes. This one is debug mode and this one is the Mule design mode that we were working earlier. And in the Mule breakpoints, you will see all the breakpoints that you have put in your project or in your complete application. As of now, we have only one. Now let's try to execute our project with the help of Postman. So I'm just going to open Postman here, and let me create a request here. So I will use localhost 8082 because I have given my port 8082, and I'll click on send here, and you can see that my request is hanging on. My request is taking time to execute. Why? Because I have put a breakpoint over there. If I go back, I can see that my process has been stopped here, and I can see what payload, that means whatever I'm sending here, is it is a blank. There is nothing that I'm sending. And in the attribute, I can see that I have headers, I have listener path that I'm listening, what is the API, sorry, what is the IP address, what is the path that actually I'm sending, and then what is the method, query parameters, everything that I'm sending here, I'm able to get here. Now, if you try to evaluate your next process, which is debugger, you wanted to see what value we are actually getting in debugger. So we have this next processor. If you click here, it will take you to next, and it will keep pausing your application. Now, if you see that we have nothing, we have a blank value for the payload that actually will be in the output. And then for the attributes, we have the same thing that we are talking about. And if you again click here, next processor, you can see that your application has successfully completed. And even if you go back here into the Postman, you can see that you are able to see a 200 status code, which is okay. That means we were able to successfully call our API, and we are getting blank value in our output that we saw as a payload. Now let's quickly make some changes into our application and then hard deploy our application. So what I wanted to do is, I just wanted to quickly make a post request from MuleSoft and wanted to see what actually output I'm getting here. So let's quickly change this method to post, go to the body, and I just wanted to send JSON body here. So I'm making sure that I'm selecting JSON as a body, and here for the body, what I'm doing is just giving a name, and I'll say SFDC Panther. And then for the email, I'm just sending two data. So I'll say sfdcpanther@gmail.com. And once I'll try to send it, you can see that my request is again hanging up. I'm not able to see the output. And the reason is the debug that we put, the breakpoint that we put here. Now, if you see in the payload, we are actually able to get the data here. We are able to see the name, we are able to see the email. And if I try to use next processor, you can see that in the payload we have the same thing. And if you again see, we will see the output here, because this output we are sending, and we are getting that here as well. And again, if you go to your console where you can see your debug because of this logger statement, you can see that we are able to see payload, whatever the payload we have is. And then even if you see here the category of debug logger that we set at our logger process, and then we have this payload, what is the payload, and what all we are getting, what are the attributes here, and what is the headers, you can see application by JSON, what we have sent here, what are query parameters, what attribute media types, everything that we are sending. Now let me clear the console. Next thing is that now we wanted to execute this breakpoint only if the method is post. So how we are going to work on that? So to do that, we need to provide expression. We need to say that whatever the method we are sending, a client is trying to request for our application. If the method is post, then only execute this breakpoint. So let's quickly select this, and on here you can see on the bottom there is a checkbox named as conditional. You need to check here, and this particular input function is actually enabled for you. Now here you need to put your data view expression. So in our previous lecture, we learned about that Mule has a message, and inside message we have attributes, we have payload, and we have variables. So how we are going to say here is, we are going to say that message dot attributes dot method, and then we are going to say that if our method is post, then only execute this breakpoint. Now let's try to save it, and once we will save this project, it will try to deploy our project hot deploy. So now let's try to check if this project is working. So first thing that we will do is, let's change the method to get, and then click send here, and let's go back here, and we will see that our project is still debugging. That means our condition that we put here is wrong, so we need to see that if there is any typo mistake. So you can see even we are able to get here, this has error. So what of how we will do is, so first let's quickly click here on this debug process, and let's load it this, or I'm going to quickly switch to my design, and then I will go back to my project that I just closed before starting of this video. I'm going to open that because I have put that expression in my this project, so I'm going to quickly reuse this. So here in debug, okay, we don't have that one, no problem, let's quickly debug this as well. So we have this, let's quickly click on this listener here, go to our output, we have attributes, and then under that we have method. So now let's quickly go to our debug mode itself, and I'll say Mule breakpoint here, message dot attributes. So here it is attributes. Okay, so let me quickly copy this expression, and let me paste here. So okay, we forgot to put this single colon at the end. So now let's try to execute this. The only error was that I forgot to type this single quotes. So now if I try, let's quickly pause this. Now we are able to get some value here. Now let's try to again send it, and let's go back here and see if our Mule is okay. Still we are getting that we have some error. So what I'm going to do is, let's right click on this attributes, click on copy expression, and then post here. So we are getting that attributes dot, I'm going to say we have an attribute name method. So this is our method, so let's copy expression as well. So I'm going to paste here. Okay, now we have attributes dot method, and we will say that equal to post. If this is the case, then only execute our this particular breakpoint. Now let's resume our application, clear our console, and again try to hit our send button, and again see if we are able to, okay, our application still is, it is saying that we have must be a breakpoint conditional result, must be a boolean. Still we are getting some error. Why it is that? So a method we are sending, that is get, and we are sending here post, and we are saying that if that method is post, then only say, and still we are getting here server breakpoint handler conditional result must be boolean, and it's and is, it is saying that it is a string. So we are going to say that fully qualified property, and it is post. Again I'll again give it a try. So let's quickly pause this, clear this console, send it again, and it is again we are getting error. So breakpoint result must be yeah. So if you are also getting the same error, what you need to do is just stop your project and try to debug it again. So I did the same and now it's working. So let's quickly try to test it. So if now you send this, you can see that we have a method get, we are calling our endpoint. If I'm sending it, I'm just getting a message. So what I'm going to see is let's send body as a none. Now try to send it and see what output we are getting here. So you can see that we are getting some error here because here if you see at the top of that we are saying that unable to parse input reading payload as a JSON while writing JSON. And why we are getting this error? Because we have some option here, we are saying that just parse this, whatever the input we are getting, parse this into JSON, into JSON. Yeah, this is why we are getting this error, and that's why our application is hanging here. So what we are going to do is now let's quickly try to go to next processor, and now we are getting error here, unable to parse empty input because we have defined there as a convert into the JSON. So what we are going to say here is we have worked on default, so I'm going to say that default. Okay, what we are getting error is okay, let's quickly say it. Now what we are going to send that in a input parameter, so let's quickly try to make that change. So in the body we are not going to, let's create another request so and try to test it again. Now you can see that we have blank value because in the earlier what it was taking JSON, whatever we were trying to send as a body, that's why we are getting the error. Now if you see that our breakpoint is not executing. Now even if I try to make change method as a post, I'm sending, and now let's try to remove this so that we can be sure that our breakpoint is working. If you send this, now our request is hanging up, we are not able to get the output. And again, why? If you go back to our studio, you will see that now our breakpoint is executing, our breakpoint is hitting because this particular condition that we have put is now met. So if you see in the payload, we have only name SFDC Panther whatever we are sending, and in the attributes whatever we discussed, now we can see that method is post. And if we go to the next processor, in the log we can see whatever the payload, the output of this transform message is the input of this debugger, and that's what we are getting here. And if we go to the next processor and go back to our postman, we can see the output here. And if we again go back to the console here, you can see that we are able to get the things at the logger level. Now let's try to send this as an error here, that means we know that this is not a valid JSON. Try to send it. Again our application is hanging up, and here you can see that we are able to see whatever the payload is. Up to here we are okay, there is no error. Now if we try to next processor, you can see that instead of jumping into the debug logger, what we are getting is we are able to see that a red sign here, that means this transform message is not happy. And if you see that there is another attributes comes up saying error, and in the error type we are seeing that mule expression, and in the description we can see here if you see that unexpected character payload, this the complete error here we are getting. And here even it is saying that while evaluating the expression into the JSON format with the help of data view expression, we are getting that error. So even we can see the error as well here while debugging. And if you see this, and we will be able to see the error here as well at the debug level because the output of this transform message is the input of debugger, and then we will be getting the same error here as well. Now let's try to revert back whatever it was and then try to send it. again we will get the same output, and if we refresh this, and we will be getting here. So up to now we have worked how we can put a breakpoint, how we can execute conditionally our breakpoint, and then now let's quickly see how we can jump up. Let's say what I'm going to do is, let me quickly go to the design mode. Again I'm going to drag and drop a set payload process here next to the logger. We have already worked on this set payload. So what I will say is, I will say that bypassed logger, and here for the payload what I'm going to say that hello there, that this is a very simple thing that I'm going to put, and then again I'm going to put a logger here. Now we have the breakpoint here, same thing, and let's quickly save it so that we can see that our application is hot deploying. That means we don't need to again execute our application, so we can see that our application is initializing. So what I wanted to show you here is our mule debug, our breakpoint will be stopping at this point, and I want to skip these two, or I want to skip this logger and directly wanted to go here in this set payload. How we can do that? So let's quickly see here, hit our send button for the post method. Now get back to our you can see our breakpoint is hitting at transform message. Now let's select this particular process and go to the menu of your debug, and here you can see there is an option run to process. If you click here, you can see that now our debugger is pointing at this, and the payload that we are getting is, as of now, the output of this debugger is SFDC Panther, whatever we are sending. Now if we again go to the next process, now you can see what is the payload, that is hello there. What we are sending here as out, sorry, what we are setting up here as an output, whatever output is getting here for the logger, the output of this will be the input of logger. That means the output of previous process will be the input of next process. So this is how you can quickly jump into the different process, or you can skip some set of process or a single process with the help of your debugger file you are working debugging your project. Now let's quickly get back to our transform message, and we wanted to run to process. Sorry, we cannot go back to previous. This is what I wanted to show you. Now let's again try to hit this, and even you see that there is hello there. Let me cancel it. You can see that there is hello there output that we were setting up here as a payload. So I'm going to resume this here again. Hit the send button. We are here. Now you wanted to get whatever output. As of now, it is a very simple output that we are able to see here. Now if you wanted to evaluate this with the help of evaluate expression, what you need to do is just right click here. If you wanted to update some values for the testing purpose, you can update value here as well. You can change, let's say that I'm just wanted to change here, I'm saying that email as email as sfdcpanther.com, and if I set here, now you can see that I have a key as email and value as sfdcpanther, and if I go to the next process, the payload that I'm getting is whatever I have set here. If you wanted to see, you can see this. This is a very simple, but in real time it will be very complicated. To see that, right click on that whatever the expression you wanted to evaluate, click on this copy expression, and then you can see that there will be a evaluate data view expression menu at the top. You need to click on that and then paste your expression there, and once you will hit enter, you will see the complete expression. I wrongly entered somewhere else. This is why we are not able to see here. So if you expand this, and if you wanted to see, you can see that this is our output. Whatever the media type is, if you wanted to see. So this is how you can quickly debug your project whenever you are working with your project. So this is it for this video. I